The showdown's about to happen right here, live from Millwall in London. Tower Bridge, a famous London monument, gateway to the Port of London. And across London's revitalised dockland, to the New Den, the sparkling new home of Millwall Football Club in South East London. Here, two sporting traditions run very deep, football and boxing. Tonight, for the first time, a world heavyweight title fight comes to a part of London enjoying a new lease of life. Tonight, it's the fight for the WBO World Heavyweight Championship. Michael Bent defending the crown against Herbie Hyde. In January, the scene was set for tonight's contest as Bent and Hyde traded punches outside a London hotel at their first meeting, a little fracas which cost each man £10,000. Tonight, it's the real thing. The challenger arrives for the biggest fight of his life. Herbie Hyde knows these parts well. He's trained not far from here, lived in Britain most of his life. He got here early, leaving nothing to chance. He's the British champion, but this fight puts him into a whole new league. He's the new boy, but he hopes tonight to do enough to make his name go right around the world. And he says he's never felt better. The champion, Michael Bent, looking very relaxed, arriving here with the usual big entourage. A short pro career so far. It's only the second time he's fought as a pro in Britain, but a wealth of amateur experience and a homecoming too for Bent. He was born just down the road from here in Dulwich. He says the key to his success is being totally relaxed and the preparation is good enough to leave no doubts in his mind. Today dawned fine and sunny, fortunately, because the second world heavyweight fight in Britain in 6 months is outdoors at what some would say is exactly the wrong time of year. But it's so far so good, and although it is rather cold out there, under the lights in the ring behind me, it's going to get very, very hot shortly. And here in our vantage point, I'm delighted to say that I'm joined by a veteran of three World Heavyweight Championship fights already, Frank Bruno, a man hungry for more. Good to see you here tonight.
Thank you very much, Paul. Nice to see you again.
People have been having a bit of dig at you the last few days, Frank.
Very, very much so, but I'm used to taking a little bit of dig here and there, you know. The guy was supposed to take me 10 rounds. I done it in the first round, so I can't do no more than that. But people are entitled to have their opinions, you know?
We'll talk in more detail about your own fight as we go along through the show, Frank. What do you make of this one tonight?
Very intriguing fight. If it's as good a fight as it was the press conference fight the first time they met, we're in for a wicked fight. You know, you never know.
I think it's going to be pretty exciting. There's an undercard fight and plenty of action going on in the ring right now, but we are concentrating on the big one. And it's not often that anybody gets to see the fighters in this kind of proximity in the moments before the fight. This is Herbie Hyde in the dressing room. Both men perhaps unknown to the worldwide audience. Tonight could change all that, though. So who are these men who hope to earn that recognition tonight? First up, the challenger. If I get any
infringements, the WBC International Heavyweight Champion, Herbie Hyde!
For Herbie Hyde, the British heavyweight champion, home is now a village just outside Norwich in the peace and tranquility of the Norfolk countryside. It's a far cry from his place of birth, and Herbie explained to me his early childhood and how he got into boxing.
I was born in India and I came over at a young age, and I went to boarding school in Hampstead near Norwich. After that, I joined the Norwich Lads Club, and I went to Crossland College as another boarding school. So I spent a lot of my years in the prep school and boarding school.
Hyde was to have a limited amateur career, losing in the ABA finals. But there was something there that interested promoter Barry Hearn.
At age 17, I got to the ABA finals in my first year with seven fights. And I knew somebody who knew Barry. And they told me that he wanted to have a look at me. And I came down and spoke to him and I told him that I wanted to be a world champion. And I told him if he didn't think I could be a world champion, he should tell me, because there'd be no work for me in boxing, because if I couldn't be a world champion, I wouldn't be a brother boxing.
Like many learning professionals, the first few fights were easy. This is Hyde's professional debut against Lee Williams from October 1989. Hyde was fighting at cruiserweight, but it was as a heavyweight that the title started to come. This fight against Conroy Nelson was the first of his title victories, but did these titles mean anything?
At that stage, they meant something to me because I was only about 20 years old. I was a young kid and I was coming up and I won the titles. And at the time, they gave me confidence because I felt that there was no one else my age in heavyweight division could do that.
At 22 years of age and standing 6'1½", we could say there's a lot more of Herbie to come. One thing's for sure, he's confident about his future.
I'm not going to tell you that I'm the best heavyweight out there because I'm not. But I'm telling you that I will be the best heavyweight out there. I'm telling you that I need time to mature. I'm a baby and I need time to get things right. And I'm telling you that beating Michael Bent will give me a great boost.
Michael Bent is Hyde's biggest test to date. A victory puts him on the road to success. But how will that victory come?
I'm going to knock him out in 2 seconds. I like an early night. I'm going to knock him out quick. I like to go out there and get the job and now. If I knock him out the quicker, I knock him out the better. I wouldn't want to go there. But I'm prepared for 12 rounds. But I love to knock him out in 2 seconds, even once. And
that's the determination we spoke about. This is the dressing room live. Hyde getting taped up. And as he does that, why don't we get a word with him? Gary Norman's down there, and I think Gary can have a word with Herbie Hyde now.
Thanks very much, Paul. Unprecedented pitches here down in the dressing room with Herbie Hyde. Freddie King is trying to go through the final preparations. Herbie, just a quick question for you. How are you feeling? 30 or so minutes to go.
I feel very good. It's time to go now. All of them. It's a little bit too tight, Fred. It's time to go now, and I'm ready to go.
I believe you spent some time with Chris Eubank, who's prepared you for how you might feel at this moment. What advice did he give you, Herbie?
That's up to me. It's not. Do not be fighting, not Chris Eubank. Chris will be at home watching. And I'll be all right.
What kind of Herbie Hyde are we going to see in about 30 minutes' time?
You are going to see the best of Herbie Hyde. I'm 20.
Yeah, hurrah.
I'm 20. Yeah.
Here we go.
And if Michael Bent was watching these, have you got a message for Michael Bent?
The belt belongs to me, Michael. And tonight, I wouldn't be denied.
Herbie, thanks very much indeed. Good luck.
New champ. Here we go.
Well, what about the champion? Michael Bent making his first defense of the title he won so convincingly last October, knocking down the great white hope Tommy Morrison 3 times in 92 seconds to join the heavyweight elite. And don't let anybody tell you that shocks don't happen.
But look at that right uppercut. Then the left arm. Tyson is down.
Holyfield is gone. Bo senses the finish now.
And now Morris turned the tables and he's got him.
Look at Bruno here coming up with that left hook. Catches him. And Bruno was hurt by that.
Oh, and Morrison is down. And Michael Bent is the champion.
Michael Bent was born and raised in Dulwich, South East London, 29 years ago. Age 6, he was to leave for Jamaica and then America. It was as a child in England that he had his first encounter with boxing.
We were watching some fight. I know it was Muhammad Ali against a European fighter. I don't remember if it was Carl Nordenberger, Henry Cooper, or Brian London. And I remember I was sitting on his lap. It was Muhammad fighting this white guy. I said, this looks, I mean, then the impression I got was, you know, that's something that I think I could do. And I was, again, 2-3 years old at the most. That's a very, very, very vivid memory for me. You know, when you grow up with something, you know, it's in your blood, that you hear it constantly as a child, you can say, well, let me give it a shot. You know, you want to make your father proud, your brother proud. So I wore the gloves, the gun shield, but yeah, the orange peel and the socks that was, you know, our boxing gloves. I had a few bloody noses and broken wrists, but it was cool.
His manager, Stan Hoffman, and trainer, Eddie Mustafa Mohammed, have had a precocious amateur talent with which to work. But when eventually Michael turned professional, it was all to go horribly wrong. He lost his first paid contest.
No excuses, I got caught. Jerry Jones was a better man that night. You try and be a better man because of it. But I didn't handle it well at all.
Bent had to come back to England to get his first win. It was December 1990, the Royal Albert Hall, and it lasted just over a minute. Thankfully, he's had some tougher contests since, and one that proved to be a good learning fight for him was a 10-round victory over Mark Wills.
Yeah, I broke my right hand in the third round, and that fight made me dig down. Mark definitely made me dig down. I learned a lot that fight. I learned a lot about the fact that I can fight, and I can dig down when I have to.
3 months later, Michael Bent was thrown in against Tommy Morrison for the WBO heavyweight crown. Morrison was a huge favorite, but Bent, as he explains, took it all in his stride.
When you weigh the scales of Tommy's pro experience and my experience as a fighter, period, he couldn't measure up. He had 38 fights, lost one, 35 by knockout. I'm Michael Bent, 10 pro fights, lost my first pro fight by knockout. Didn't make any kind of Olympic team, wasn't pursued by any big names to turn pro, and I was given no chance whatsoever, no chance. Tommy gave me his best shot, I took it, and I gave him mine, he didn't take it, you know? It's all, you know, give and take, man. You know, and we all occupy, if I wear a size, say size 12 shoe, all I occupy is 12 inches of space on this earth, man. Nothing more. So Tommy was no big god in my mind. He was a man like me. If I hit him, he would cut. If I hit him, he would hurt. And with a body shot, he would bleed. You know, so again, I didn't have a big picture angle of Tommy Morrison. I just simplified. He has two hands, two legs, two eyes. If he had three hands, I'd be worried. You know what I mean?
That upset, some say, against an ill-prepared Morrison has escalated Bent to a level of greatness. Hyde is all that stands in his way now, and he's an opponent that Bent is very respectful of.
Any man with two hands, Gary, you know? Again, I learned my first pro fight, man. You don't sleep on nobody. I've worked too hard, man. 18 years. 18 years of getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, you know, in Queens, New York. When it's so cold outside that the perspiration is freezing up on your face. When you breathe, it burns because your lung is like it's on fire. 18 years of that, you know, and I worked too hard just to give it up.
He doesn't intend to give it up, but there's no speaking to Michael Bent. At this time, we got a word with Herbie Hyde, but Michael's brothers from the Nation of Islam have politely but firmly told us that Michael will be speaking to us after the fight and not before. That's Bent's dressing room, and we're just a few moments away from fight time itself. Now, Frank Bruno, I just wonder about the value to fighters of this WBO World Crown.
A lot of people are knocking it. We're saying it's understandable knocking it because it's IBF, WBC, WBA, and more championships. You know, it makes it a little bit confusing because it's about... Johnny Nelson's got a world championship, so it makes it very, very confusing, but a title's a title.
Do you want honest. One? A WBO World Heavyweight Championship?
I prefer a WBC, IBF or WBA championship rather than WBO, to be quite honest, because people understand that, you know, you're world champion when you've got them championships, you know?
But if you get the chance, you're not going to turn it back, are you, Frank?
I'd be foolish not to, you know what I mean? I'd be foolish to turn it down, but my aim is to go for bigger and the creme de la creme, or cream de la cream, or whatever you want to call it, Paul Dempsey.
Let's have a look around outside, shall we? Just a few minutes away from big fight time now, and I mentioned in this part of London, this is boxing territory down here in southeast London, and the locals come out to support their fighters, and they've done that again here tonight. It's a magnificent venue also for boxing. More from Frank Bruno in just a moment. Also, our men at ringside are taking their places down there. Final minutes now in the countdown to the world heavyweight title fight, Bent versus Hyde. The new den at Millwall in London's Docklands. It's bitterly cold here tonight, but they've come out to support the big fight all the same. Just to remind you of other major occasions coming up on Sky Sports. In 5 weeks' time, on the 22nd of April, in Las Vegas, the IBF and WBA world champion Evander Holyfield defends his title against Michael Moorer. That is bound to be a thriller. On May the 6th, our very own Lennox Lewis goes into the ring in Atlantic City to meet Phil Jackson, defending his WBC world crown. Both those title fights live and exclusive to Sky Sports. Let's get down to ringside as the atmosphere builds up, shall we? And
yes.
Say hello to our big fight commentator Ian Dark.
Indeed, I just wonder whether this is going to be the night for Herbie Hyde. So far in Cheltenham week, you could kind of line it up like this, that he's been a novice chaser who has been winning some easy races, and now they're putting him into a kind of Cheltenham Gold Cup. But there are one or two questions, too, about Michael Bent. OK, a 93-second win over Tommy Morrison. But apart from that, he, too, hasn't been fighting anybody who's been ripping up too many trees. Glenn McCrory with me, as always. Glenn, what kind of feeling do you get about this one?
I've got a good feeling. Obviously, it's not the biggest fight in the world. It seems to be a second division heavyweight fight, but I've got a good feeling about it. I think it's going to be a good fight there. They're quite evenly matched. They're both unknown quantities. One's a better boxer, one's a better puncher. So I think it's all there to make a very good fight.
We've been thinking about the strategy for this fight. Herbie Hyde is reckoned to be the faster, more mobile of the two. And this is the way we think are the key points for Herbie Hyde to win the fight tonight. We think he mustn't freeze, must he, Glenn?
He hasn't. It's a big night for him. He's got to be relaxed. He's got to get straight into his boxing. He's got to use the speed, the mobility. You know, it's all there for him. We say they're throw fast combinations, and he's got to get the bench chin, because we saw in his world title fight with Tommy Morrison that his chin looks suspect. So as quick as Hyde can get to, he's got to get to it.
One or two stories, too, about King Ifitan, a sparring partner, putting Bent down in the gym and having him in some trouble. He's also had a bit of trouble with a virus. That's the key point for Herbie Hyde. He's a stone lighter. He's going to be the faster of the two, we would think. As for Michael Bent, we think these are the key points for him tonight. Glenn, you'd think he'd have more power, wouldn't you?
You would. He's the heavier of the two. He's been around the heavyweight division longer. He's a natural heavyweight. So he's got to use that strength. He's got to try and cut Hyde up. He's got to get to his body and really use his power and his strength. And I think he's got to maximize the extra power. He's got to get close to him, get him in the corner, and really let the big shots. And we'll see if Hyde can take them.
So that's the strategy for the fight. Who do you fancy here? Michael Bent starts a 2-1 on favourite Herbie Hyde. Maybe a sporting bet at 6-4 against.
As usual, Ian Dark finds the right odds. Frank Bruno up here with me. Frank, is that how you would read the fight, the way the boys put the pros and cons down?
They're working as Pinky and Perky there. They're working as a good team, you know what I mean? Michael Bent, you know, I don't know too much about him, but as the amateur career, what he's had, he's been in the America spine with Riddick Bowe, Evander Holyfield. He's been around professionals and he seems more seasoned than Herbie Hyde, you know, but you can't take nothing away from Herbie Hyde because he's undefeated, he's got fast hands, he's very, very confident, but I'm not too sure if he can handle the sort of like pressure with the big night and everything like this. He may freeze, he may not freeze. We'll know within the next 15 or 20 minutes time, but it's a very intriguing fight, Paul.
It is, and that's the fascination of the big showdown in world heavyweight terms. It brings all the stars out. Gary Norman's down at ringside, and I think he's found one or two important people to talk to.
Thanks very much, Paul. Well, I'm joined by my old sparring partner, Gary Mason. Now, I remember a story you telling me about 5 years ago. Watch out for Michael Bent.
Yes. My experiences with Michael Bent is that he's a very, very good boxer. And at the time when I was working with him, Michael was a confused person. He didn't know where he was going in his life. And since he's found this new religion of Islam, and then a title opportunity come along, and he won the title. As you know, when you win a title, it adds a lot of self-belief, and when you've got something to believe in as well, it strengthens the mind. So I think Michael comes in here with a lot of strength. Herbie, he's had a lot of winning fights, but there's been some debates as to how good the opponents have been and things like that. But you can't knock an unbeaten record.
That's right.
And it makes for a very, very good fight. I see this something as if it's like a rabbit and the hunter. Mm. And Michael Bent will be the hunter and Herbie will be the rabbit. And can the rabbit outsmart the hunter?
Well, Herbie impressed me with how cool he was in the dressing room and Michael wouldn't talk to us. Do you read anything into that?
Well, I do know Michael's a very temperamental person, but he's got a lot of people around him at the moment.
That's right.
And it's very difficult to get to him with all the people around him. But one of the main things I've always thought about the two fighters is that Herbie has got the mentality of a young man, whereas yeah. Michael has the mentality of an older man. And that, again, I think is a very is an additive to the whole situation.
Well, it's minutes to go now, so thanks, Gary. You take your
Thank
seat ringside. For the moment, it's back to you.
Thanks to both the Garys. Let's have a little look around out here, shall we? This is the new den.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a
Southeast London, the heartland of boxing.
I'm sure you're just dying.
And we're just a few minutes away from big fight time now. The first leg of Sky Sports Heavyweight Grand Slam of 1994. And we'll be with you after this commercial break for the ring walks. And then the main event.
Also, with us this evening, we have the number one contender.
You're watching Sky Sports.
The new den in London, a crowd of around 9,000, we hear, have shown up to see Michael Bent's first defence of the WBC World Heavyweight title. And just time to remind you of other top sporting action on Sky Sports in coming days. Tomorrow, as the second test continues on Sky Sports, over on Sky One at 3:30 p.m. Super Sunday, Sheffield Wednesday against Blackburn Rovers from Hillsborough. Can Rovers keep up the pressure behind Manchester United? Monday night football starting at 7 p.m. Mike Walker goes back to Carrow Road as Norwich City meet Everton. And don't forget Wednesday night, Cup action, FA Cup sixth round replay, Luton Town versus West Ham. But now for the knockout punch. Let's get down to ringside. They're on their way, and it's time to say hello once more to our big fight commentary team, Glenn McCrory, and first to Ian Dar.
Thank you very much indeed, Paul. Yes, the tension's rising a little here at ringside. There's been quite a big walk-up gate on the night. The promoters will be happy about that. It's a chilly old night down at the den, but thankfully it has stayed dry. Otherwise, we might have had chaos with the condition of the ring canvas. We await now the entry of the two boxers. Herbie Hyde, I know, has been very, very relaxed. They say walking by the Thames today, down by the tower, not far from here. And Michael Bent, I hear, has been asleep. He's that relaxed in the dressing room. And we await now the entrance of the two boxers. Paul Thomas, the referee, waiting in the ring. Usually, of course, it's footballers like Jamie Morley, Casey Keller and Alex Ray that the locals pay homage to on this very pitch tonight. World Championship Boxing. So there's the crowd just waiting. Tickets, by the way, tonight priced between £20 and £150. And Herbie Hyde, the British heavyweight champion, but so far yet to convince really the boxing aficionados that he is a fighter right out of the top draw. Tonight he can go some way to proving that. People have rubbished this WBO championship, and it's absolutely true. It doesn't have the same credibility as the one held by Evander Holyfield or indeed Lennox Lewis, but the winner here tonight can possibly start to think of himself as being in that kind of league. Well, certainly on the fringe of it, and maybe get a shot at one of those two. Alan Hughes, the MC, waiting to do his stuff in the ring. So, Herbie Hyde about to make his entry to the ring, we understand.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the New Den, the home of Millwall Football Club, live and exclusive on Sky Sports and shown on SBN in the United States of America and in Holland and Scandinavia on Filmnet. Will you please welcome into the ring for the WBO Heavyweight Championship of the World, the challenger for the title, Herbie Hyde!
Well, it's a really theatrical entry from Herbie Hyde, who tonight tries to confound the critics who say he's too small for the big league of heavyweights. I must say, earlier in the week, I thought he seemed a bit tense and was kind of talking himself up. But today, he's been very relaxed, according to those closest to him. Herbie Hyde, who says tonight, I'll be lightning fast, too fast for Michael Bent. Born in Nigeria, but remembers very little of his early childhood in Africa. He was brought up by his adoptive parents, Allah and Tinan, in Norwich. That city has caused a few shocks on the football front in recent times. Can Hyde bring a version of the World Heavyweight title to Norfolk tonight? Freddie and Jason King there beside him. Father and son will both be in the corner for 22-year-old Herbie Hyde. He calls himself the Dancing Destroyer. He's quick, he throws punches from all sorts of unexpected angles, but there are those who think he's little more than a blown-up cruiserweight. Herbie says tonight he has a secret plan to beat Michael Bent, which he is about to unveil, of course. There's Freddie King on the right there, the Matchroom Stables trainer. Certainly the biggest night so far in the life. For the entrance of the Anglo-American Michael Bent, who really did shock the world when he beat Tommy Morrison in 93 seconds to win this championship. He had Morrison on the floor three times in the opening round after being in a lot of trouble himself. Now you'll notice all those people around him. He is, well, you can see them through the smoke, you will anyway. He has a deep Islamic faith. He has a lot of his Muslim brothers around him, the most prominent of which is a gentleman who calls himself Leo X. Well, almost surreal, isn't it? The entry of the champion, Michael Bent. 29 years of age, born in London, at Dulwich, based in New York. He's still blowing his bubbles as well, as he did when he came into the ring against Tommy Morrison. And that really is a sign of just how cool he is. He can blow bubbles. They're supposed to do that at West Ham, not Millwall, aren't they? Bent is a witty, articulate, intelligent man, an avid reader who says he used to skip school to go to the library. Not many fighters who can claim that. The entry of Michael Bent, who's been boxing since he sparred as a little boy with his brother, using orange peel for gum shields.
Will you please be upstanding for Land of Hope and Glory?
is our MC, Alan Hughes. Before that, why don't we just check on the vital statistics of the two fighters. Bent is 7 years older. He's a wee bit taller as well. Look at the weight difference, a stone wall for Bent. That's not a surprise. Hyde has always been light as heavyweights go at the top level. And a slight reach advantage, we think, for Herbie Hyde, but not very much. Hyde unbeaten in 25 fights. He hasn't really fought at the top level yet. Bent, who's only had 12 professional fights, but an awful lot of amateur fights, 167 in all. Hyde, though, as a professional, on paper, more experienced, though Bent has easily the best win of either of them so far, that one against Tommy Morrison. Those are the rules tonight. The 10-point must system, that means that the winner of each round must get 10 points. If it's even, it'll be 10-10. The loser will usually get 9. If there's been a knockdown, it might be scored 10-8. That's the basic way it works. No standing 8 count. The 3 knockdown rule will be in effect. The fighter can only be saved by the bell in the last round. And, of course, only the referee can stop the fight. In other words, not a ringside doctor, though very few referees would ignore the advice of any doctor.
Ladies and gentlemen, promoted by Bob Arum on behalf of Top Rank Boxing and Barry Home for Matchroom Boxing and sponsored by the Thompson Directory, we now come to the main attraction of the evening, a heavyweight contest over 12 rounds each of 3 minutes duration for the WBO Heavyweight Championship of the World. Your judges at ringside, Andre van Grootenbrule of Belgium, Harold Lederman from Orangeburg, New York, Roy Francis of England. Your WBO supervisor in charge is Mark Scheckner of Miami in Florida. And your British Boxing Border Control stewards in charge are John Clifford and Dr. Ross. Ladies and gentlemen, your timekeeper is Danny Peacock. And when the bell rings and the action begins, the referee in charge of the four-cornered ring is Paul Thomas of England. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing and presenting to you the boxers. First, in the red corner with the white shorts, with a 100% career record of 25 wins, 25 contests, 24 inside the distance, and weighing in at 15 stone 6 pounds from Norwich, the reigning British heavyweight champion, the reigning WBC international champion, and the reigning WBO pentacontinental champion, and challenger for the title, Herbie the Dancing Destroyer! And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in the blue corner with the black and the multi trim shorts with a professional record of 11 wins, 12 contests, 6 inside the distance and weighing in at 16 stone 6 pounds. He lives in New York. He comes from East Dulwich, ladies and gentlemen. Will you welcome, please, the reigning WBO heavyweight champion of the world? Rounds of boxing for the World Heavyweight Championship. I thank you.
Paul Thomas is the referee who will now give them their final instructions. He's from Derby.
You know what I expect? I expect a good clean fight. Obey my instructions at all times. Okay? Best of luck to both of you.
So here we go. We've seen the unscheduled fight in the puddle, an unseemly sight it was too, that cost them both £10,000 in fines. This time it's Hyde Bent 2, this time legit with gloves, and the venue moves to the Den Millwall open air on a mid-March night. So away we go, due to go 12 rounds for the WBO Heavyweight Championship, Bent in the black shorts. As you can see already, much the bigger man, and with just a little bit, the hint of a spare tire around his waist, Glenn McCrory.
Yes, just ever so slightly. He looks in pretty good shape, pretty solid. Hyde's going to have to use his movement. He's going to You want to be stepping around, using that long jab.
We thought Michael Bent might be looking to go to the body of Herbie Hyde to just slow him down, because we would expect Hyde to try and maximise his speed, be the more mobile of the two, get in and out with quick combinations and away again. Bent, who took only 93 seconds to win this title against Tommy Morrison. Just having a little spasmodic success there early on. There is just a question mark about whether Bent can actually take a punch. He was put down in sparring by King Ipitar. Henry Akinwande had him on the floor as an amateur as well.
Well, Hyde's getting his shots off, nice combination there. And as we saw earlier on, he did seem to land with a good right hand, which just seemed to send a shudder through Bent.
Bent was absolutely top class as an amateur. He reached the Olympic box office in 1988, and he was a four times national Golden Gloves champion in the United States. He says he was the best amateur never to box at an Olympic Games. Should have plenty of boxing skill.
It's very early at the end, but Hyde looks quite sharp. He's moving quite well, and that's a nice sharp left jab.
Bent in only his 13th professional fight. Be interesting to see whether Hyde can test that chin of Bent's early on. He was in a bit of trouble even when he won the title against Morrison. Cautionary word for Bent from Paul Thomas, the referee.
Yes, I think the heads were rubbing a little bit too close there, Ian.
And Hyde getting through again, this time with the left hook. He's started well, the British heavyweight champion. Good opening round for Herbie Hyde. Well, what did you make of that, Glenn McCrory? It was certainly a good start from the boy from Norwich.
It was a good start, and he looked confident, he looked very quick. And he didn't look overawed, and that was one of the key things that we said, that he didn't have to freeze, and he didn't freeze in that round.
He's certainly not freezing now. They're using the tin foil in the way they do with marathon runners to make sure he stays warm on what is quite a chilly night. It's not freezing by any stretch of the imagination, but I certainly know they've not got a roof over their heads tonight.
Yeah, it is a tad chilly, Ian.
Well, Herbie Hyde showed his speed in that opening round there as he takes the instructions from Freddie King in the corner.
He did, it was a confident start. He looked nice and quick.
Second up. Round two.
There's some of the shots he got up a little bit tight there.
Second round, Hyde showing no signs of being overawed. The British champion in the white shorts. Bent hasn't really found his rhythm or timing as yet.
Well, Hyde's doing the right thing by making him follow him. He's using his feet, so Bent hasn't been able to get set.
And the right hand landing to the side of Bent's head, and he just wanted to hold on for a moment there. It didn't seem to land that cleanly. Hyde just getting the cautionary word from the referee. Bent with this stone advantage in weight. You'd expect him to have more power, though. Speaking to an American journalist, Mike Katz, who's very close to him, he says he doesn't think Bent is really a puncher.
Well, the thing that we saw in the Morrison fight was Bent, was Morrison coming on to Bent, which obviously doubled up the power.
Bent gets through for the first time.
That was the first time he got through some shots, and they looked pretty crisp and pretty solid.
Take a right cross, and a very fast right cross. Suddenly there, Bent showed a lot of his class.
Yes, that's good work from Bent. He looks very, very fast when he lets them shots go.
You don't survive at the top of amateur heavyweight boxing in the States and compile the kind of record he did, 159 wins and only 8 defeats, without having a bit of skill and style and class. Was Bent just biding his time, watching early on and seeing what Hyde had? We'll see.
Bent still just following Hyde around a little too much. He's got to cut the ring off, get him into the corner.
I don't think it's his natural style to chase Bent. He's more the counter-puncher himself.
Yes, judging by his little fast combinations, it looks that way.
Second round here, and those who thought Herbie Hyde might be a little bit overawed by his elevation to this kind of level have been wrong. He made a fast start, took that opening round, weeping. Bent's come back a wee wee bit more in round two, though. Every possibility of a fascinating fight developing here. That's the scene live at Millwall's New Den. You're watching the WBO Heavyweight Championship fight between Britain's Herbie Hyde and the British-born, though American-based, Michael Bent. Two rounds gone, and it's pretty evenly poised so far. Round three, Hyde in the white shorts. That's how we're seeing it so far. Hyde with a slight lead. He won the first round. We think round two was even. That's a very approximate guide to how it might be going. Of course, the judges are the ones that count. Again, Hyde using his speed and getting away again.
Yes, he's very quick. He's doing the right sort of game plan. He's moving well. He's just catching with that jab very fastly and then getting out of there. I think he obviously feels that Bent is strong and he doesn't want to mix it with him too much.
Herbie Hyde, who's been conditioned for this fight by Jim McDonnell, the former featherweight and super featherweight world title contender. And Jim, who has always superbly conditioned himself. Bent so far has only shown us little glimpses of his talent. The jab and move tactics working for the moment for Herbie Hyde.
Yes, Bent hasn't got off with a great deal of shots. He's done a little bit too much stalking. He's not really cutting the ring off and getting to Hyde quick enough. He's allowing Hyde to use that jab and just build up points.
What answers does Bent have for this? He's got to cut off the corners and maybe start to attack Hyde to the body, you'd feel. It's a good jab from Bent, a sort of ramrod look about it. Oh, right uppercut was a good shot from Hyde. Bent was just hurt a little bit by that. He's down. Well, how about this? In round three, Bent on the floor. Is he going to get up? He's nine, he's back against the ropes. That must have been perilously close to being counted out. Bent is in trouble. Is Herbie Hyde here about to collect the WBO heavyweight title? And again, he counters off the ropes there, Bent, just as he did against Tommy Morrison. Hyde here senses that this may be his moment. Bent is hurt again by the right.
Bent is in a lot of trouble here. This is very good moments for Hyde.
Can he finish the job here in round three? Bent shakes his head as if to say he isn't hurt. but I would suggest that he is most certainly wrong. Herbie Hyde there was within an iota of winning the fight in that round, but Bent sacked back to his stool, and now they know that the prize can be theirs in that corner.
Certainly, that's got to give him all the confidence in the world. I think it all started from a very good uppercut. He put Ben on the floor, and then he never loved the punishment, and Ben was in serious trouble there. He came back with one flu. There's the right uppercut. He got all his weight behind it. Great shot.
It was another good left hook as well, wasn't it?
But it was all came from the uppercut.
Look at this again. He's picking the punch as well, isn't he?
He is, and he's getting through. From where we sat, we couldn't see where the punches were landing, but they were getting through, and he had Bent in serious trouble there.
Picking up. Round.
Well, this is dramatic now. Fourth round coming up. How much has Bent managed to recover in the minute's break? Can Hyde get him under pressure early in this round? If he can, he may well get this job finished. There was always a suspicion about Bent's ability to take punches, and I think we have an answer.
I think we have, and we can see what Bent's trying to do. He's trying to draw Hyde in. He wants to try and do the same thing that he did against Morrison. He wants to make Hyde make mistakes, but at the minute all he's doing is making Hyde hit him.
There was too a little question about Bent. Why had he only had 12 fights in nearly 5 years as a professional? He was knocked out in his very first professional fight against Jerry Jones and took 22 months off after that. How much is he really in love with the game? Questions beginning to surface here.
You certainly are. Hyde is baffling him at this moment with his speed and his fast hands.
Again, Hyde looks for that right uppercut. That was the punch that started it all off for him in round three.
And the problem that Bent's having with Hyde's good movement style, Bent isn't getting any shots off.
Again, he's really unloading Hyde. Clusters of punching. His speed is just too much for Bent at the moment. Speed and variety.
I come clean in there with a low shot.
I was going to say, Glenn, it's easily the most impressive night's work we've seen yet from Herbie Hyde.
So far, it's a great performance from Herbie Hyde. He's sticking to his game plan, he's moving well, he's using the jab to good effect, and his combinations are tremendous.
In case you're just tuning into this, let me tell you that Bent was in terrible trouble and on the floor in round three. This is the fourth.
These last couple of rounds have kind of took quite a bit out of Hyde. He's going to felt the pace a little bit through that. Threw an awful lot of shots.
Can Bent come back? Well, he's taken a low blow, Hyde. He's complaining to the referee. That's not a good sign.
No, and he's done that a few times through this round.
Bent is covering up well. He's taking quite a few of those punches on the gloves, it should be said. Bent must hope that Hyde runs out of gas somehow and slows down. From Bent, right on the bell there. Well, something of a comeback there from Bent. Welcome back to the New Den at Millwall. The scoring so far, well, it says 70 there at the bottom. It's actually, we're seeing it as big for Hyde so far. Scoring punches, 70 to Hyde, 33 to Bent, landed. And that tells its own story. Fifth round, Herbie Hyde, the British heavyweight champion, looking for his moment of glory in the white shorts here.
The word from Hyde's corner, Ian, during the break, where they were telling him just to calm down, take his time a little bit and just be cool.
He already knows, though, that he can hit and hurt Bent.
Yes, I think he's got to listen to his own instincts, and if he feels that the opportunity's there, he knows if he lets the shots go and he puts them in combinations, he's going to hurt Ben. I think that's a good idea to capitalise on it now.
Well, a lot of people read something into the fact that Bent was the heavier man by a stone. That was fully expected and thought he'd have more power, but it's Hyde's mobility, his speed, that is proving the vital factor here. And again, Bent is in trouble. He was opened up there. Cowering on the ropes here, Hyde could finish the job in the fifth round. It looks like his night at the moment. And Bent there is just waving him on in. It's almost as if he's waiting and looking for a counter.
It is a little bit of panic coming from Bent. He's looking to try and find this big punch.
He's breathing very heavily as well. He looks tired, doesn't he?
He looks tired and hurt. A great performance from Herbie Hyde.
He's bossed this from the word go. Herbie Hyde. So far, we've only given Bent a share of round two. Oh, left hook from Hyde, another good shot.
For a young man, Hyde's also shown good patience. He's not rushing in, he's not rushing in to try and finish the job. He's standing off, he knows Bent's dangerous, and he's not going to fall into that trap.
Bent now is just trying to entice him in and try to catch him with counters, isn't he?
He is. It looks very clear, and that's what he's trying to do.
Cat and mouse there at the moment. Hyde isn't buying it. It's not quite a truce, but close to it. Bent's corner are shouting at him, "You've got to step in, Mike." He'll have his own ideas about how to play this strategically, but whatever it is he's done so far, it hasn't worked.
It hasn't. At the moment, he's allowing too much room between himself and Herbie Hyde. And Herbie Hyde, with his speed and his reflexes, is getting his shots off and then getting out of distance. Bent needs to get to him closer.
Well, after waiting all century for a British-born world heavyweight champion, we got one with Lennox Lewis. Will we get another one here with Herbie Hyde? That's the scene at the Den in Millwall, and it's proving so far something of a glory night for Herbie Hyde. He's had Michael Bent down. That's how my scorecard reads so far anyway. 50 to Hyde, 45 to Bent, which means that the champion has an awful lot to do. Herbie Hyde is putting on a very impressive performance, and I can imagine just how excited they're getting about this up in Norwich, where they've never ever had a British champion, according to our research and records, let alone a man who can hold a version of a world title.
That's a good performance for Hyde, but he has the room. Bent isn't getting close enough to him. He's given Hyde the room to get his shots off. And that's what he's doing.
Again, the hand speed of Hyde, too much for the WBO champion. All sorts of things could open up for Herbie Hyde if he can secure the victory here. He's making Bent look positively pedestrian.
He is. He's making him look very slow. Bent just doesn't know what to do. He's just totally dumbfounded. It's Hyde's speed, and Hyde's doing the right thing by, he's not standing in one place. He's throwing his combinations, throwing his single shots, his jabs, and then moving.
Well, Michael Bent is fond of saying that when he gets into the ring, there are four men in there. Him, his opponent, the referee, and Allah. Well, he certainly needs help from somebody at the moment.
He certainly does.
You just wonder, though, whether there might be some kind of twist in the plot here. I've seen fights before where one fighter's dominated for half the contest and then There's been a turnaround. Maybe one punch might just change the mood for Bent. He'll have to hope so.
Well, we know Bent can punch and we know he's still there, so he's always got a chance.
He hasn't troubled Hyde at all so far, has he?
He hasn't landed with very few shots at all. He landed with a combination in the first round where he looked quite good. Apart from that, there hasn't been a great deal.
Well, again, Hyde complaining to the referee. He's saying that Bent bit him there. He bit me, says Hyde. And Paul Thomas, the referee, is saying, if you do that again, I'm going to have you out of here, to Bent. He's threatening him with a disqualification. That may be a sign of just how desperate Bent is becoming. Well, I think Hyde is just giving Bent a few verbals. That was what that was about, the riot act being read to him.
Well, I think Bent obviously just doesn't know what to do, and he's trying everything. Even a little bit of the illegal tactics.
Hyde in control. Well, I wonder what Frank Bruno, who's also watching the fight with us tonight, is making of it so far. What do you think, Frank?
It's a very, very good fight. Herbie Hyde is doing very well. You know, he's using his speed against Michael Bent. Michael Bent's coming in all the time. But Michael Bent don't look right to me. He's not well balanced tonight or nothing like that. But all due respects to Herbie Hyde, he's doing a very good job. Nice movement, fast hands and that. Mickey Duff said that Herbie Hyde would use his speed against Michael Bent, and it's working for him.
Thanks, Frank. Now, does Hyde have the mental strength to hold on to this now and not make any silly errors? Now, here's the biting incident.
That's right, you can see there, obviously he's very close, and you can see by the pain in Hyde's face, he obviously did get him. Yes, you can see he's right in the... Oh, yes. My word. Right of the vampires.
Wow, a scene from the jungle, wasn't
unbelievable.
It?
Unbelievable.
That's incredible, really.
That's the first time I've ever seen that, especially in a world heavyweight title fight.
And referee Paul Thomas there, you probably heard that, saying, now come on, concentrate, I want a clean fight. He knows about the jaws episode that Bent produced in the last round. This is a seventh.
Yeah, Bent's doing everything he can to try and upset Hyde's stride, try and knock him out of his stride. But Hyde still looks very cool and relaxed. The instructions he's getting from the corner are just to keep boxing, keep in control, nice and cool, and just keep sticking out his jab.
The one thing that worries me about Hyde is the amount of times that he has been speaking and complaining to the referee. Often that's an indication that of a kind of distress signal from a fighter. Probably not in his case tonight, but you don't like to see it.
No, you don't, but I think he's got a reason to do that when the guy starts biting him in.
Sure.
Bent's starting to use his jab a lot more. I think the corner must have told him to do that, because in the early rounds he hardly threw it at all. He was just following Hyde without throwing a jab. Now he's starting to use it.
He's got to step up his work rate in a big way, hasn't he, Bent? He's beginning to do that in this round, though.
He is. This is the first time we've seen him when he started to come behind the jab.
Hyde is throwing rather less of those fast combinations for the moment, but here he goes again. And Bent leaving himself open, rode the punch as well.
He did. The first few in the combination missed, but he caught him with one good right hand.
And again, Hyde complaining that that punch landed on the back from Bent.
Yes, Hyde is complaining a lot. And a few things like that are going to happen where Bent shots go astray because Hyde's moving such a lot. You know, he's twisting his body around. So a few will land in straight places.
Well, Hyde is dancing and moving, and he's producing the right hand and the crowner, and he's got him again. The cluster of punches, and will Bent get up this time? The count is 5, 6, 7, 8. He's not going to make it, I don't think. 9. No, he's knocked out. Up too late this time, and Herbie Hyde has won the WBO Heavyweight Championship. He's caused the upset. He's confounded the critics. He's beaten Michael Bent. And it was a thoroughly deserved victory. He had the speed, he had the mobility, and he had the punch. And Bent, you have to say it, was completely outclassed. Herbie Hyde, welcome to the big league.
Yes, and he deserves to be there. What a great finish to that. He just jumped in with a lightning fast combination, left, right, and down Bent went. And Bent actually, when he hit the ground, he bounced.
He didn't want to get up, I don't think, Bent. He didn't want to get up.
Yeah, he didn't. He made a last-ditch jump just on the 10, but no, I think he knew that he was out of his depth, and that Hyde, it was a tremendous performance.
Well, tremendous scenes for this young man who hasn't had it easy in life. His natural parents left him behind. He was brought up by Alan and Tina Hyde in Norwich. What a proud moment for them. And I know there's a personal story behind this as well for Herbie Hyde, with his six-year-old brother suffering from leukemia. And I dare say he'll dedicate this moment to that six-year-old boy. It's a sweet, sweet moment for Herbie Hyde. His 26th straight win, but it means more, much more, than all the other 25 put together. Magic moment for a fighter, Glenn.
Oh, obviously this is a moment he's been dreaming about for the best part of his life, and that, you know, he's going to enjoy it to the full. And it was a great way to win the fight. He boxed superb, he kept very, very cool, followed the corner's instructions. A brilliant performance.
Well, that's good to see after all that. No biting that time, I don't think. Here's the end.
What a beautiful right hand. He just jumped in, but the good thing about him is he doesn't just throw single punches, he throws them in twos and threes, and he landed with a great right hand there, Ian. We just see it, he just dives in, there's a good right hand, but then he keeps the punches flowing, and there did the damage. You see him bounce off the canvas.
His legs just went completely from underneath.
Absolutely, they just shot back behind him, and he bounced on the canvas, but it was that first right hand that did the damage.
Well, there are those who say that the WBO Heavyweight Championship doesn't mean anything in the United States. That is very probably true, but it's going to make people respect Herbie Hyde, and he now must be considered when you start to talk about the world's better heavyweights. It's a great moment for him, and all sorts of people now will wonder about Herbie Hyde against Frank Bruno, maybe. We'll maybe hear about what Frank thinks about that in a moment. Or Herbie Hyde against Lennox Lewis. They're all possibilities now, and big paydays could be waiting for this 22-year-old. Well done, Herbie. Terrific performance. You can take nothing, nothing away from him there. He did it, and he did it in great style.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 2 minutes 50 seconds of round 7, by a count out, the winner and the new WBO Heavyweight Champion of the World, Herbie Hyde!
Well, he's got his friends, he's got his family up there with him to share the moment, and why not?
Ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation please for the loser, Michael Bent!
Mixed reception for him, but a terrific triumph for Herbie Hyde from Norwich and Norfolk. And that's his young brother, Alan, who is suffering from leukemia here tonight. Isn't that great to see you too? Well, wonderful performance from Herbie Hyde to win the WBO Heavyweight Championship in the 7th round.
To both boxers, Michael Bent and the new champion, Herbie Hyde.
I wonder what Frank Bruno thought about that. He's up with Paul Dempsey at the moment.
You never know in this business, do you? He was a big favourite, Michael Bent. The word in the days before the fight was that maybe not everything was right in the camp. Herbie Hyde certainly did the homework and came to the ring perhaps in the best condition that he's ever been in his life. And when the big question was asked about young Herbie Hyde, he delivered the big answer. We promised you a bit of a thrill. And it was a thrilling performance from Hyde. Frank, we are a little surprised by Herbie Hyde's performance, are you?
Not surprised. He'd done a very good job on Michael Bent. You know, he used his speed and calm and collective, but I wasn't very impressed with Michael Bent. He didn't seem strong, he didn't seem right, he didn't seem like he got into the fight from round one, you know what I mean? But all respects to Herbie Hyde, he'd done a very good job.
The key thing, and the most surprising thing of all, I think, is that Herbie Hyde was the man who was going to fight on the outside and keep mobile, right, and not the guy to go in and knock out a bigger, much bigger heavyweight, yeah, like Bent.
It's very, very surprising. He used his speed and he caught him very, very well. You know, I think he never recovered from about round three when he knocked him down. You know, he's always Daisy, Michael Bent, but, you know, all due respects to him, he'd done a very good, done a number on him, actually, you know? Michael Bent, he'd done a very, very good number on him, and all respects to him. Very well done.
You can see how much he's enjoying those moments. Yeah. It's the culmination of all the years of work since he started fighting at the Norwich Lads Club in Norfolk. And there'll be a bit of a party on in Norwich tonight, I'm sure, to crown the new world heavyweight champion, Herbie Hyde. In short, it's a dream come true.
I'd see you sometimes on your unending cries. I knew I had to have you, my whole tender man died. Now you're by my side and I feel so good. I'm nothing to hide, all there that I ever could. Do you hear what I'm saying? Gotta say how I feel. I can't believe you're here, but I know that you're because they are true, yeah. Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm with you. You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong. Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm with you. You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong. Baby, so hold me so tight. Push your arms around me, you make me feel so safe. And you whisper in my ear that you're here to stay, yeah. Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm with you. You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong. Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm with you. You know you got to have hope.
Herbie Hyde, 26 fights, 26 victories, and 25 of them by knockout. WBO World Heavyweight Champion at the age of 22, and we'll talk to him after this.
You're watching Sky Sports.
Here at Millwall, let's talk to the man who's created all the big news here. Herbie Hyde's with Ian Dark.
And here he is, the WBO heavyweight champion, Herbie Hyde. Herbie, that was a magnificent performance. Did you ever dream it could be as sensational for you as that?
Well, before I start, I'd like to say something. My manager, Barry Hearn, my trainer, Freddie King, they had hope in me. They slagged me, saying I ain't going to do it, this, that. People slagged me. My mate, Jono, people told him I wasn't going to do it. And Jimmy, McDonald. He trained me. He was running with me every morning at 5 o'clock, and Fred was training me in the gym. And a lot of people with the press saying Barry's taking a risk, putting me for help, that I should be slowed down, just talking behind my back, saying I'm not going to do it. And I've done it. I like to say, I want to beat the man who beat the man who beat the man.
You proved a lot of people wrong, because there are a lot of people out there who are saying Herbie Hyde is not the real deal, but now they're going to have to take you pretty seriously.
I'm 22 years old. I turned professional with Barry, and I've been training with Freddie King, and I've been running with Jimmy. Things are going well. I want to beat the man who beat the man.
So who do you want to fight next?
The man who beat the man who beat the man. So I want to unify the division.
You want to fight Holyfield, Lewis, Bruno, who?
I want to beat the man who beat the man. Bruno is gone. This is my time and my era. I've said it and I say it again. Frank, your time is gone. You never get a title chance. This is my belt. You've run away from me. You're not going to touch it. You're not going to smell this, Frank. Yeah, you're listening, Ari. You're not smelling Ari. It. I love you. You're a nice guy. You're my hero. I watch you. I used to watch you at school. You're a great man, but I'm not fighting Frank. I want to fight the man who beat the man who beat the man. I like Frank. Frank is my hero, but I'm not fighting him.
Tonight, speed and mobility were the key things for you, and in the end, your punch power too. You found him out.
People say I can't punch. People say I'm too light. People say this. They slag my manager off. They said he's taking their rigs. Is this us?
Now,
Chris Eubanks.
Here's the knockdown.
You can fight. I've been tested. I got hit. I took the punch. I can fight. You can't take nothing away from me. Michael Benn is a great champ. He's a great fighter. He beat Tommy Morrison. He won the Golden Glove. He bashed up Riddick Bowe in sparring. He done everything. People slagged me off. I had confidence in people who were behind me. Barry Ham, Freddie King, Jimmy McDonald, Barry McGregor, Chris Eubanks, Jonah. Everyone had come to my friends. They all ran me, and I've done it.
All sorts of things were going on out there tonight, all sorts of verbals, and he bit you at one stage, didn't he?
Yeah, he bit me. He tried all the trick. He knows I can't. Tonight, I wasn't going to be denied. My little brother's got leukemia. He's fighting in hospital, and I have to fight tonight. My brother will recover, and he will beat leukemia like I beat Nigel Benn, and like I beat Michael Benn. Our plan, when he was in hospital, I said to him, Alan, I'm going to bring the belt back for you, and you're going to come at hospital. Alan, the belt is now. You're going to be at hospital, and you're going to be well, and you're going to watch me become a unified division.
You're dedicating the fight to your little brother, Alan, who's got leukemia.
Yeah, my little brother, Alan. I cried up last week. I was crying in press conference. I was crying in a gym. People thought I was scared of Michael Benn. I was crying because every time I think of my little brother and my mum, I cry because I love him. And my little brother, he's 6 years old. He thinks I'm a hero. I had to win tonight. Nothing was going to stop me.
It's a great moment for you.
Great moment. Still a great moment. Thanks, Barry, Freddie King, Jimmy McDonald, Jonah, Franco, Robo, everyone, Frank Turner, all the matchroom people, and all the Norwich fans are bringing it home for Norwich. I'm taking this back to Norwich tonight.
It's a great night for Norwich. Let's bring Barry Hearn in for a moment here, because he's a man who pulls a few strings around here. Barry, just tell us, what's next, you think? Because Herbie says he doesn't want to know about Frank Bruno, but the public might, and you're a money man.
Listen, let me just say, I'm not even thinking about what's next. What I've seen tonight is such an important moment for British boxing. You've got a real heavyweight champion of the world here. Not a fella that comes over from Canada via Jamaica and lives here for 3 weeks. Not a fella that comes over here and pretends, you know, he was here for a few years, 25 years ago. I'm talking about someone who's been born and bred here. And for my team at Matchroom, for Freddie King and everyone there, this is the result of what we believe investment in sport is about. Taking a young man, 17 years old, putting our time, putting our money, believing in him. And he is now repaying our belief. And this is a message to everybody. You can't beat us. You know, you can try. You can go behind corners. You can whisper in ears. You can't beat us. Because we had a match and we got fighters like Herbie Hyde. We've got other great fighters coming through. And we're going to continue putting our money where our mouth is. Freddie King is going to train and runs a great operation. He's done a wonderful job on Herbie. We've got the talent. Herbie Hyde now will develop into the greatest heavyweight fighter this country, perhaps the world's ever seen. I said to you last week, we're at the dawn of a new era of heavyweight boxing. Everyone said, oh, you know, he's biased. This is what we've seen. This is the second coming. This is the second coming of Ali. Watch the style.
Well, this is heady stuff, Barry. I mean, how do you think he compares, say, now with Lennox Lewis? How would that go?
Oh, listen, Lennox Lewis would get bashed out. Lennox Lewis wouldn't last 5 rounds, you're joking.
Can Freddie speak?
Freddie King, let's just bring Freddie in here. Freddie King is the trainer. Freddie, it's a big moment for you too. You've helped Herbie to this moment. What's your thoughts about it all?
Well, when I first see Herbie, I said he was an uncut diamond. As I was a good cut man, I would make him a gem, and I think I've proved that tonight. He's absolutely brilliant, and he will he will achieve what Barry Hearn said. Mind you, he's only 22 years old. All the other heavyweights are 29, or 30, 31. He's only a baby, and he will be a great heavyweight, and I will endorse what Barry Hearn has said.
It was a strategic triumph, wasn't it, in there tonight, too? The speed, the mobility, those were key points.
They were plans, and I said that it would go to 7 or 8 rounds. I told other local news reporters that was what would happen.
You were wrong, it was 7.
Well, 7 or 8.
It was a good call anyway. You got the right winner.
That's all I wanted.
It'll be a fair old party up in Norfolk tonight, won't it?
I'm sure they will be.
Well done, Freddie, and well done the Herbie Hyde camp.
Thanks to Ian, with some delighted connections of Herbie Hyde down there. Well, he's put the word against you, hasn't he, Frank Bruno?
That was hype. That's more than Don King hype, wasn't it? You know what I mean? But, boy, good luck to me. They want to spoil their sort of like they're having a nice time at the moment.
This is their big night, and they're quite entitled to it because they've done all the hard work.
Yeah.
Now, you are pushing around the 30 mark.
I'm pushing.
Exactly. The one good thing about this young man for the sport is that it's a shot in the arm for a different group of boxers.
It's nice that he's going to keep the title over here, because if Michael Bent would have won it, he would have took it back to America and then sort of like milked it over there. So it's nice, you know. But it's the WBO is not still as powerful as the IBF or whatever, but I can't take nothing away because people are watching in Norwich and that, and he's won the title, so good luck to him, God bless him.
Talk us through it from your point of view, one fighter on another.
Right, he was moving like he was moving from the first round, very relaxed, and boom, right there. Right hand, and he's following it up. Very nice performance.
Now, in his early days, he was a one-punch knockout merchant, Herbie Hyde, but in the last year or two, Frank, against some rather mediocre boys, he's had trouble putting them away.
Right.
And he comes out tonight and he puts away the WBO World Heavyweight Champion.
The WBO. Michael Bent is a very, you know what I mean, good fighter, but today he just wasn't right from the first round. You know, his body never felt, he never looked tight or whatever. But I don't want to take nothing away from Herbie Hyde because he'd done a good number, a good job on him, you know what I mean? But he just wasn't right, Michael Bent, you know what I mean? Whether, you know what I mean, he was ever better than what he could do tonight, whether the Morrison fight was a fluke, but take nothing away, because like you can never take nothing away from an unbeaten record. You can never take nothing away from a guy that has won a title, the WBO, whether it be WBC, whatever, he's won tonight, and good luck to him, you know.
But the other really surprising thing, I think, for a lot of people with such little experience at the age of 22, he fought a cool fight,
very very cool, you know, because Michael Bent was trying all the tricks under the sun, head down, knocking him near his tools, you know what I mean, biting him at one stage.
I've never seen that before, have you?
I've never seen that. I've heard about it, but I've never seen it. It's like Jaws, man, you know what I mean, getting on his shoulder and just trying to take a chunk out. I don't know what that's going to prove, taking a chunk out of his shoulder, but
psychological warfare, and he withstood it very, very well, didn't he?
Very, very well. He was complaining a couple of times here and there, but I think if someone bit you or hit you in your tools, you would complain, you know?
Well, don't kick me under the table. Let's have a little break, and after that, we'll be talking to more of the people who've been making news here at Millwall on a big boxing night. We'll see you in just a moment.
You're watching Sky Sports.
The big question hereabouts at Millwall is how good can Herbie Hyde go on to be? A former great of the ring, Barry McGuigan, down at ringside, might have some of the answers about that. He's talking to Gary Norman.
Thanks very much, Paul. Well, Barry, what did you read into that? It was a bit of a one-horse race.
I have to say I was disappointed with Bent, but I did watch a couple of tapes on him a few months ago. Herbie asked me, you know, have a look at the tapes and see what way I should fight this guy. I said, look, just stay on the outside of this guy. Circle the periphery of the ring, keep the left jab going. I said, don't get off before him. Don't let him get set, and he won't be able to hit you. I said, he's very poor coming forward, and I have to say, he didn't disappoint me. Hyde boxed beautifully. Boxed a tremendous fight, used his left jab perfectly well, set him up and hit him with the right hand on a few occasions. Looked like he was going to go, and then finished the job in magnificent style.
How good can this boy be? 22 years of age, 6'1½". There's a lot more to come.
Yeah, he's run into an awful lot of criticism over the years, and I've watched him and commentated him on many occasions, and I have to say that whilst he does have bad habits and does drop his hands occasionally and, you know, does back up against the ropes and drop his hands, he's got awesome reflexes. His speed as a heavyweight is quite incredible, and he punches extremely hard, doesn't have like the one punch finish that some of the heavyweights have, but he punches extremely hard and extremely often. Got great all-round boxing ability, and he's 22 years old. He's right there on the highest echelons of the sport, and he's coming through. He's going places, believe me.
What would you do if you were sort of managing him now? Where would you sort of next defence?
I would give him several defences before I would match him with someone like Michael Moore or the likes of Evander Holyfield or Lennox Lewis. I would give him at least three or four defences against top-notch opponents, and then he's ready. He needs a bit of time to develop and get better, but believe me, he's got the talent, he's got the ability, and you know, people are going to read about Herbie Hyde for a long time.
I think you're right. Well, thanks, Barry. Back to you, Paul.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks to both of the guys down there at ringside. One footnote to the fight, we've heard that Michael Bent has been taken out of the arena on a stretcher and he is now in an ambulance on his way to hospital. If we have any more news of that, of course, we'll bring it to you in the time that remains. In the meantime, Frank Bruno and I will review some of the highlights of a superb performance by Herbie Hyde, and we start in round three when it all started to go wrong for Bent.
Evenly poised so far. Round three, Hyde in the white shorts. That's how we're seeing it so far. Hyde with a slight lead. He won the first round. We think round two was even. That's a very approximate guide to how it might be going. Of course, the judges are the ones that count. Again, Hyde using his speed and getting away again.
Yes, he's very quick. He's doing the right sort of game plan. He's moving well. And he's just catching with that jab very fastly and then getting out of there. I think he obviously feels that Bent is strong and he doesn't want to mix it with him too much.
Herbie Hyde, who's been conditioned for this fight by Jim McDonnell, the former featherweight and super featherweight world title contender. And Jim, who has always superbly conditioned himself. Bent so far has only shown us little glimpses of his talent. The jab and move tactics working for the moment for Herbie Hyde.
Yes, Bent hasn't got off with a great deal of shots. He's done a little bit too much stalking. He's not really cutting the ring off and getting to Hyde quick enough. He's allowing Hyde to use that jab and just build up points.
What answers does Bent have for this? He's got to cut off the corners and maybe start to attack Hyde to the body, you'd feel. It's a good jab from Bent. A sort of ramrod look about it. Oh, right uppercut was a good shot from Hyde. Bent was just hurt a little bit by that. He's down. Well, how about this? In round three, Bent on the floor. Is he going to get up? He's nine. He's back against the ropes. That must have been perilously close to being counted out. Bent is in trouble. Is Herbie Hyde here about to collect the WBO heavyweight title? And again, he counters off the ropes there, Bent, just as he did against Tommy Morrison. Hyde here senses that this may be his moment. Bent is hurt again by the right.
Bent is in a lot of trouble here. This is very good moments for Hyde.
Can he finish the job here in round three? Bent shakes his head as if to say he isn't hurt, but I would suggest that he is most certainly wrong. Herbie Hyde there was within an iota of winning the fight in that round, but Bent sacked back to his stool. And now they know that the prize can be theirs in that corner.
Certainly, that's got to give...
And I wasn't at all surprised to see Bent shaking his head as he went back to his stool, because he realised at that point, Frank, that he was in a serious spot of bother.
Yeah, it was a good uppercut what caught him, you know what I mean? And he didn't sort of, like, recover. He was shaking his head and trying to come in to sort of, like, draw him into the Tommy Morrison situation when Tommy Morrison had him on the ropes and hurt him and got back to him. And, he never recovered from that third round, you know. But as we were saying beforehand, he didn't look too... He looked very weak, you know, like something was drawn out of him.
Yes, he did. And I mentioned just a moment ago that he has actually been taken away from the arena. in an ambulance, and here is the ambulance leaving the new den and on its way to hospital for what we hope will be a cursory medical inspection. The British Board of Control, I just should point out as well, have been pressing for this kind of medical supervision at fights, Frank, and for
it's
ambulance.
So important, you know what I mean? Because, like, boxing's going to take a lot of stick, like every other sport. They always say, you know what I mean, bring this, that, and whoever knows what, with the Michael Watson situation. It's been tightened up, and now it's nice to see that there's, you know, ambulance and that available to take people to hospital to get a further checkup.
Paul. Absolutely right. We're hoping for the very best for Michael Bent, of course. Resuming the fight coverage there, round four certainly went the way of Hyde. Let's have a look at what happened in round five.
Fifth round, Herbie Hyde, the British heavyweight champion, looking for his moment of glory in the white shorts here.
The word from Hyde's corner, Ian, during the break, where they were telling him just to calm down, take his time a little bit and just be cool.
He already knows, though, that he can hit and hurt Bent.
Yes, I think he's got to listen to his own instincts, and if he feels that the opportunity's there, he knows if he lets the shots go and he puts them in combinations, he's going to hurt Bent. I think that's a good idea to capitalize on it now.
Well, a lot of people read something into the fact that Bent was the heavier man by a stone. That was fully expected and thought he'd have more power, but it's Hyde's mobility, his speed, that is proving the vital factor here. And again, Bent is in trouble. He was opened up there. Cowering on the ropes here. Hyde could finish the job in the fifth round. It looks like his night at the moment. And Bent there is just waving him on in. It's almost as if he's waiting and looking for a counter.
It is a little bit of panic coming from Bent. He's looking to try and find this big punch.
He's breathing very heavily as well. He looks tired, doesn't he?
He looks tired and hurt. A great performance from Herbie Hyde.
He's bossed this from the word go. Herbie Hyde. So far, we've only given Bent a share of round two. Oh, left hook from Hyde. Another good shot.
For a young man, Hyde's also shown good patience. He's not rushing in, he's not rushing in to try and finish the job. He's standing off, he knows Bent's dangerous, and he's not going to fall into that trap.
Bent now is just trying to entice him in and try to catch him with counters, isn't he?
He is. It looks very clear, and that's what he's trying to do.
Cat and mouse there at the moment. Hyde isn't buying it. It's not quite a truce, but close to it. Bent's corner are shouting at him, you've got to step in, Mike. He'll have his own ideas about how to play this strategically, but whatever it is he's done so far, it hasn't worked.
It hasn't. At the moment, he's allowing too much room between himself and Herbie Hyde. And Herbie Hyde, with his speed and his reflexes, is getting his shots off and then getting out of distance. Bent needs to get to him closer.
Well, after waiting all century for a British-born world heavyweight champion. We got one with Lennox Lewis. Will we get another one here with Herbie Hyde?
I know the answer. It was to be yes, and highlights of round six and seven in just a moment or two. But let's go down again to ringside. And John Morris, the secretary of the British Boxing Board of Control, I think can update us on Michael Bent's situation. John Morris with Gary Norman.
Well, one or two disturbing reports about the condition of Michael Bent after the fight tonight. John Morris, the secretary of the British Boxing Board of Control. John, what is the latest situation?
Well, Michael's been taken to the London Hospital. The ambulance, of course, was here and ready, and one of the board senior medical officers has gone with him. He wasn't well in the dressing room. Clearly, he suffered some kind of a concussion, and although he began to respond to the doctors and to answer questions, they decided that precautions came first, and they've taken him to hospital.
Is he still conscious?
Yes, I believe he was.
What would be the situation? He's gone to the London Hospital now. Just tell us what the backup is, because people will have horrible recollections of the Michael Watson night.
Well, the backup, in fact, is exactly the same, that the paramedics were on duty and were with the doctors when they went into the dressing room. The doctor had already had a look at him and said, I'll come and have another look at him in a minute or two, because he'd gone back to the dressing room. And, of course, the ambulance was waiting outside, as the ambulances have been doing all evening. The nearest neurological unit, which was the London Hospital, had been alerted to the show, and one of the board doctors contacted the neurological unit by telephone from here immediately that we knew that he was going to go to the hospital.
How concerned are you at this moment about it?
Whenever a boxer goes to hospital, I'm very concerned. But the chief medical officer, or the deputy chief medical officer of the board, is here as well. He's just had a look. He hasn't actually examined him, and he is hopeful that this is just a precaution, and he will stay there, of course, at least tonight, and I'm sure they will do some scans and tests and find out exactly what the trouble is, if there's any problem other than the fact that he had a very hard contest and he's very exhausted.
We hope and pray that he's okay. Thank
we
you, John.
Certainly do.
Thanks to John Morris with Ian Dark, and of course, just to repeat the point, we really couldn't wish for any better medical care at this time for Bent. He's certainly in good hands. Back to the fight action, and we'll pick it up in round six with what Frank Bruno, I think is fair to say, we have not seen in a ring for a very long time, if ever. Talk me through this tactic, the use of the bite.
Serious jaws. Serious bite.
That was presumably was the frustration.
See, look at that. Look at that. Oh, God. Yeah.
Herbie didn't like it, did he?
I don't think nobody would like it unless you're that kinky.
And even with a gum shield in your mouth, that is going to hurt, isn't
very,
it?
Very, very much so. You can see him shouting there. Look at that, you know? Vampire. I don't think you see that too often, and so blatant, you know what I mean? But still, he must have been desperate to try and do something, like he was trying his head, trying to hit low, down, below and everything, you know?
Herbie checking out the damage on his shoulder.
That's right.
But the frustration of Bent in terms of the fight going against him was obviously...
There was
just
something wrong with him, you know what I mean? I know, you know, you can get frustrated with a moving sort of like guy, but he didn't seem to have any strength in the, you know, like when he was going forward, he just, you know what I mean, pouring out, and he didn't have no, he didn't seem tight or well balanced, nothing like that. But as I keep on, I don't want to sound like a rapper or a parrot, but you can't take nothing away from the performance from Herbie Hyde, but Michael Bent was very disappointing. There must be something wrong with him, you know what I mean? Like, as he was knocked out in sparring in America, and he was about Ram Jam or whatever, you know what I mean?
Ramadan. Well,
Ramadan.
The story was that because of his religious beliefs, he wasn't actually eating during the days of daylight
hours. For a
week,
he went drinking or something like that.
And his manager, Stan Hoffman, said he was dehydrated as well.
Yeah, very crazy. But still, I would have thought he would have capitalised on him being the WBO champion, taking it from Morris. Tommy Morrison, he would have tightened up and everything, but still, good performance.
Herbie was the man seizing his chance, though.
Right.
Round seven next.
Stop boxing! Take time! Take time! Johnny Bozier, I'm not letting this fight get out of control. You've got all these intent, but you know, and everything else. I want a clean fight. Clean fight. Both eyes been great.
And referee Paul Thomas there, you probably heard that, saying, now come on, concentrate, I want a clean fight. He knows about the Jaws episode that Bent produced in the last round. This is a seventh.
Yeah, Bent's doing everything he can to try and upset Hyde's stride, try and knock him out of the stride. But Hyde still looks very cool and relaxed. The instructions he's getting from the corner are just to keep boxing, keep in control, nice and cool, and just keep sticking out his jab.
The one thing that worries me about Hyde is the amount of times that he has been speaking and complaining to the referee. Often that's an indication that a kind of distress signal from a fighter. Probably not in his case tonight, but you don't like to see it.
No, you don't, but I think he's got a reason to do that when the guy starts biting him in.
Sure.
Ben's starting to use his jab a lot more. I think the corner must have told him to do that, because in the early rounds he hardly threw it at all. He was just following Hyde without throwing a jab. Now he's starting to use it.
He's got to step up his work rate in a big way, hasn't he, Bent? He's beginning to do that in this round, though.
He is. This is the first time we've seen him when he started to come behind the jab.
Hyde is throwing rather less of those fast combinations for the moment, but here he goes again. And Bent leaving himself open. He rode the punch as well.
He did. The first few in the combination missed, but he caught him with one good right hand.
And again, Hyde complaining that that punch landed on the back from Bent.
Yes, Hyde is complaining a lot. And a few things like that are going to happen where Ben shots go astray because Hyde's moving such a lot. You know, he's twisting his body around, so a few will land in straight places.
Well, Hyde is dancing and moving, and he's producing the right hand and the crown, and he's got him again. The cluster of punches, and will Ben get up this time? The count is 5, 6, 7, 8. He's not going to make it, I don't think. 9. No, he's knocked out. Up too late this time. And Herbie Hyde has won the WBO Heavyweight Championship. He's caused the upset. He's confounded the critics. He's beaten Michael Bent. And it was a thoroughly deserved victory.
It certainly was deserved and merited. And Frank Bruno, the only question was, when was he going to finish it?
When was he going to finish it? Yeah, from the third round, that's what we were saying. When was he going to finish it? It was round 7, Paul,
that he
finished it.
We spotted. And he's destroyed the man in terms of his punching power. That's the one message that's been taken away from this performance. That
very,
he's got
very
power.
Much so. Yeah, he has got power. Speed, I think, yeah, he's got power. He hasn't got a sort of like a boom, you know what I mean? Speed sort of like power.
A snap punch.
Yeah, snap, that's it. And I'll try it on you.
Whereas you've got the big, solid...
Yeah, boom.
Don't try that one on me.
Right, I won't try that.
Let's look ahead to April the 22nd instead, shall we? Evander Holyfield, the IBF and WBA World Heavyweight Champion, in the ring again against Michael Moorer. Can Holyfield, the great survivor, do it yet again? When you hear the exciting prospect Michael Moorer goes in to face the force of Evander Holyfield. Nobody in the world today knows more about championship boxing than Evander, the real deal, Holyfield. Join us May the 22nd. In a moment or two, more from the New Den. Stay with us.
You're watching Sky Sports.
We wait to find out who Herbie Hyde fights next for the WBO world title. But Britain's WBC world champ Lennox Lewis is already preparing for his next fight in the USA when he meets Phil Jackson on May the 6th.
Please welcome the defending WBC heavyweight champion of the world, Lennox Lewis.
Owen Weaver's down. The right hand from Lennox Lewis.
Looking to finish it, uppercut right, Fitz is all over, that is it, finish, third round, Lennox Lewis does the job.
Lennox is looking for angles to try and explode his bombs, but it's all Lewis and he's got it again.
Yeah!
Lennox stay on track in 94. Join us for his first fight of the year against Phil Jackson, Sky Sports, May the 6th. Heading the undercard here at Millwall tonight, a young man who created a sensation in the USA in his first year as a professional. The Olympic silver medalist at the Barcelona Games, Wayne McCulloch from Belfast, has gone 11 unbeaten. He's already into the world title picture at bantamweight. He's trained by Eddie Futch, there is no better, in Las Vegas. They call him the Pocket Rocket. And here he is in action against Mark Hargreaves from Burnley, another 23-year-old. We join it in round three.
Third round, the exciting Wayne McCulloch in the plain black shorts here. Hargreaves with the stripe down the side. Just got the impression in the second round that McCulloch was really beginning to slip into his highest gear.
He was. I think all his gears are pretty high.
Yes. Starts in fourth and goes up from there. He's got more gears than most.
It is, and Hargreaves has got a bit of a swell under his left eye, so he's feeling the effect of McCulloch's punches.
Hargreaves a bit swollen around the left eye. He gets home with his own left foot. And give him absolutely full credit. The crowd at the Den quite engrossed in this. All the boxing journalists who soon have to cast their vote for Young Boxer of the Year, sizing up McCulloch. They won't have had too many chances to see him live. It's his English debut. He has fought in Belfast and Dublin, but usually in America.
Nice jabs as well from McCulloch. He really twists into that jab. Gets a lot of power behind it. Hargreaves still doing well. He's still managing to tuck up inside and taking quite a few shots on his gloves.
He's quite clearly come into the ring tonight, Hargreaves, nurturing a dream to be the man to put a dent in Wayne McCulloch's record. He's come in with great ambition. But it's beginning to get a little unrelenting now, the pressure on him.
It is, that's the thing that's going to get him, I think, the fact that McCulloch never lets up. He's non-stop, and obviously Hargreaves coming in at short notice, he's going to get tired.
I must say, to fight at this pace, McCulloch really must be a fantastically conditioned fighter.
Yes, he does look in superb shape. He's not carrying an ounce.
McCulloch, former top amateur, and well, who's to say he won't become a top pro too? Terrific stuff. He really is throwing the punches and clusters. Look at the variety now, and this is becoming altogether too much for Hargreaves. Referee Roy France is just beginning to take a harder look at things. There's less coming back now from the young man from Burnley.
Yes, this is tremendous stuff from McCulloch. The combinations just never stop, just one after the other. Fighting a tremendous pace and with great accuracy.
There's nothing coming back at all now, and I wonder where Roy Francis might step in. It's about any second, that's it. No, it was stopped before the bell went. The fight is over, and McCulloch has won it.
And that's professional win number 12 for the Pocket Rocket from Belfast. You'll be hearing a great deal more about Wayne McCulloch. Let's close with a word with our special guest tonight, Frank Bruno. Never far from the headlines, and yet again this week, Frank, on the back of all the newspapers all week, perhaps for the wrong reasons, I have to say. You demolished the American Jesse Ferguson in just 142 seconds the other night. It was a pretty one-sided affair, I have to say that. First, before we talk about it, let's review the closing moments, shall we?
Frank's going for the big win here. He wants to beat Riddick Bowe. And Ferguson is offering nothing in resistance. Got a lump coming up at the side of his left eye. Ferguson has gone down for the second time. Well, all you can say is that Bruno's going in doing his stuff, and Ferguson is woefully vulnerable, woefully weak.
You got a lot of stick for the performance.
Very much so. The guy went in with 8 world champions. He put £2,000 bet on himself, and he was supposed to take him the distance. A lot of boxing writers, boxing experts said that it would take me 8 rounds, 10 rounds, and he said that he was going to beat me and do something what Bonecrusher Smith couldn't do, this one couldn't do, and I stopped him in one round. And if he would have stopped me, you know what I mean, it would have been much more, it would have been front page, not back page, but
sure.
I beat him and I can't do no more than that.
I understand that from a fighter's point of view. Mm. Why are so many people in the media having a go at you this weekend?
I don't really know. It's best you ask them, you know what I mean? Because, like, a lot of people in the media, they picked the eighth round. They said that he's a durable guy. He just took Ray Mercer. He beat Ray Mercer about 6 months ago. He just went 10 rounds with Ray Mercer, split decision and things like that. And I don't know why they're having a go at me, you know what I mean? Harry Mullen from the Boxing News said it was a good performance. Mm. A lot of people said it was a good performance, but I don't know, you know what I mean?
The final thought would be, though, Frank, that, you know, so many people do have so much time for you. We'd love to see you crown your career with winning a title.
Right, yeah.
Maybe you've got to get in there and fight for the title as soon as possible.
Very, very much so, you know what I mean? I've got to sit down with Mickey Duff and see what sort of, like, plans he's going to do and see what offers come in on the table and take it from there, you know what I mean? But I just got to talk to Mickey Duff and see what moves I'm going to do now.
I believe Riddick Bowe's also got his eye on this WBO crown now.
Yes, I hear that Riddick Bowe's got his eye on the WBO title, but I would like to go for, you know what I mean, the WBC, IBF or WBA title rather than the WBO championship, to be quite honest.
Right, but say it doesn't happen, Frank, because you've been frustrated so many times with negotiations.
Very much
so. You wouldn't turn your nose up at an all-British affair with Herbie Hyde for this WBO crown,
you know what I mean?
You?
Like they put a sort of like a constructive enough offer on the table and don't come with silly offers here and there. You know, of course I wouldn't turn it down, you know what I mean? I'm a professional sort of like boxer, and you know what I mean, I'm into the game to sort of like do what I can for myself, like everybody else is in the game. You're in this game to do interviewing game or whatever, you know what I mean, to do whatever you can for yourself. But my the person who does my sort of like wranglings and talking and whatever is Mickey Duff. So anybody who wants to put an offer on the table, like I got an offer this week from George Foreman to sort of like
on that Foreman thing, Frank, I think a lot of people, massive respect for Foreman and also for yourself,
but
we'd prefer to see you not fight Foreman. We'd prefer to see you fight Herbie Hyde, Riddick Bowe, and win. We'd love that to happen.
Yeah, very much so.
So well, can it happen?
Yeah, it can happen if they can come up with, if the two promoters can talk and we can sort out and iron out the creases. Yeah, most definitely, yeah.